现在我们已经到 Brooklyn Museum 这儿了，今天天气真好。这个 museum 门口还有一些摆摊的，啊，这味道真香哎！多热闹今天。这边就是 Brooklyn Museum 的门口了。今儿这天儿多好。现在要排队进去，人还特别多今天。今天是 Brooklyn Museum 200年的，所以人超多。进来了。Wow, so cute.
Happy birthday celebration at Brooklyn Museum.
Sweet.
Thanks so much, all of you, for joining us. How many of you have already walked through the exhibition? Anybody?
Okay. We have these here. So those were intentionally chosen because they look like the mist rising through.
这个是差不多300年前做的。他做的这个是跟水有关系。
And these vessels, on these vessels, you see representations of fish.
On rain. And now we're living in a world of extreme weather, extreme climate events.
And I want to call attention to Courtney Leonard's sculpture, Artifice, from the Breach series, relations with the land. What does it mean to take care of the environment and view it as a relative, as an equal?To humans, not as a resource of different tribes, holding up miniature, also see them extending out to the viewer, these little baskets. And then when you come and do some close look at that, and then I'm gonna pivot and talk to these about these baskets over here.
Serpentine.
Yes. extremely close, knows that chocolate is indigenous to the Americas. Did everybody know that?
Yes, yeah. The natural world. To illustrate how indigenous folks think about gratitude within this community.
I'm made of leather,
but what is used to adorn them is actually porcupine quills. So as I mentioned in the other gallery, porcupine quills and animal hair embroidery, those were really important artistic traditions.
And making offerings of gratitude and expressing one's reciprocal relationship, not only to the natural world, but to fellow human beings, was very important. So the act of
wow.
It's hyena. It's from May's God, emerging from a flower. And it's also a whistle. When they blend this herb, and they're almost like they're a totally worker, and the Métis are known as the floral beaver people. And so we see a woman. This ceramic piece here underwent a radical transformation with a lot of loving care from Fair Top on the top of this. So we're going to come all the way to the end of
the room. 栩栩如生的这个展厅的名字叫黑白展厅 Black and White。
It works from the ancient Americas of animal effigies to promote the fertility of birds.
另外这个展厅都是跟古印第安人的一种性崇拜有关系的画儿。
Probably 95%, maybe even more, of the artworks in the galleries are from our collection. We do have select bones from different collectors, and this is one such bone. This is a work by Nation Spirits. That's not the case for all indigenous communities, but within select communities, these individuals were revered all over. But here, I want to call particular attention to these beautiful pink snarls on her abdomen and legs. And to me, this sort of alludes to her sculpture. Among the Chica, meat figures are very rare. And in fact,
you see all of these low portraits on the wall.
And the reason why I'm hung so low is that we're trying to take the heads of households. They could have been the heads of an ancestral lineage, but they would have been literary objects that have been placed in a burial chamber.
A Lakota person, most likely, who lived on the planet. They didn't have seven houses before colonialism. They followed the buffalo. And you need perhaps the painting behind you, or figures seated with eyes closed. In case of the Naomi figure, she's sitting, her eyes are closed, again, hands on hips, an allusion to our fertility. All the subjects in this gallery looking out, looking at you as the visitors.
So, by having a minor, here we see Maria behind on the side here. This is a Moche portrait that's from Mold Lake. And we've seen portraits of the same individual. You can tell that they're reproducing the same individual over time. So this is in fact a portrait. We don't know who this person was, but it's an actual portrait of a person
at the museum. And remember back in Flowers, I mentioned ceremonies called potlatches that took place in the Pacific Coast, where a chief would feed everybody and give lavish gifts, because within that community, the poor, there's a human figure of the central face and a bird below. So when we think about Native art museums,
北美印第安人的文化延续了几千年了，而且他们的艺术还是在继续制造之中。这个房间的展品全部都是跟花有关系的，包括这个包，这个是18几几年的时候绣出来的，现在看还是特别精美。这个艺术家我们上次在迈阿密看到他画的几幅画， 这是18世纪1700年画的一幅画。旁边这有一幅画，这是1934年一位日本画家画的，这个女士是他的女友。这件艺术品是200多年前，也是北美 Nova Scotia， 就是现在的加拿大的印第安人做的一个艺术品。它整个的这个作品是用刺猬的皮做的，非常非常的精美。这是1915年的一个陶器，也是 indigenous， 就是北美印第安人雕的。他的脸部表情雕得非常有意思。这一幅也是 Sasha Gordon 画的，在迈阿密也有一个他的 gallery， 全部都是他的画，而且他都是自己做 model 自画像。现在要看这个部分是布鲁克林当代艺术家的现代作品。这个现代的博物馆里头，我最喜欢这一幅画，可以看到他最后的眼睛里泪水都能看出来，所以当时他一定很悲伤。现代艺术品虽然是不太懂，不过有一些还是看得挺有意思的，比如像这一只黑猩猩竟然还有一些粉色的头发。今天的博物馆逛得差不多了，看到了好多新的作品，谢谢您的观看，我们下次再见。 Thanks for watching.